Yesterday, a major landslide struck Switzerland, specifically 130 kilometers east of the city of Geneva. This occurred in the Alps at the village of Blatten, completely obliterating the vast majority of its structures numbering in the hundreds, causing at least $300 million in damage and resulting in one person still sadly being unaccounted for. The landslide in question had been detected initially on May 14th, which gradually increased in volume and speed until smaller collapses began, leading to the evacuation of Blatten on May 19th. 1.5 million of a deemed unstable 5 million cubic meters had collapsed by then, with the remainder finally all collapsing at once, along with additional unaccounted for portions of the surrounding mountainside on May 28th. As a result, the area I have marked on screen, spanning 2.31 square kilometers or 571 acres, has been buried by at least 8 meters or 26.2 feet thick of rock. This 2-minute-long landslide was detected by regional seismographs as equivalent to a magnitude 3.1 earthquake, as well, yes, the landslide itself did not generate an earthquake, it did create seismic waves which could be and were measured. This is why if you go on the US Geological Survey earthquake website, there's a drop-down option you can tick to specifically search for detected landslides. While this is not a good method of comparing landslide volumes, we can see that the seismic energy equivalent to a magnitude 3.0 earthquake was detected due to a landslide at Alaska's Lucia Glacier on September 13, 2023. That landslide was determined to have a volume of 10 million cubic meters, potentially suggesting that yesterday's landslide had a volume of at least 12.58 million cubic meters of rock, vegetation, and ice. I have updated my graphic to better represent newly geolocated data, meaning that 343 structures have been destroyed and 28 have been damaged. Yet, the damage figure today is already quite higher, as 33 additional structures have been flooded, some up to their second story by the now landslide-dammed Lonza River. I estimate that the overall river has, as of the publishing of this video, risen by 9.5 meters or 31.2 feet behind the dam, meaning anything below that height above the original river height is now flooded. Water is continuing to pool at a rate of 5 cubic meters per second, or a full Olympic-sized swimming pool worth of water is added every 8 minutes and 20 seconds. While this is once again an educated guess, it seems to me that the newly created lake behind the dam will rise another 10 meters, affecting this shaded area by 7 a.m. local time on June 1st. About 432,000 cubic meters of water is being added every day to the now 532,800 cubic meters of water that has caused the flooding observed thus far. Since it is, in my opinion, quite likely that this landslide dam will eventually be breached and lead to a flood downstream, multiple settlements have been partially evacuated close to the river. Additionally, further evacuations have been ordered to all of Weissenried, as while the major landslide stopped just short of the center of that village, there is now a risk of additional landslides, some of which have already occurred today. While at least a few 100,000 cubic meters of rock on the original ridge, which was the landslide source, is still deemed to be unstable, there is also the recently emplaced large landslide deposit, which itself is also potentially unstable, especially on steeper terrain. This means that now both the north and south of the river valley can experience said form of additional landslides, which will be made even more likely to occur during the next few heavy or just general precipitation events. Whether or not the Lonza River will breach to specifically create an outburst flood is uncertain, and I want to remind everyone that the situation here is likely quite different than it was last summer at Canada's July 30th landslide that blocked a portion of the Chilcotin River. The Chilcotin River is truly a major river in Canada, with an average flow rate of around 110 cubic meters per second of water, while the Lonza River is only a minor river in Switzerland, with an average flow rate of only 5 cubic meters per second. Thus, looking at the 5.5 days it took for the Chilcotin River to breach the landslide dam last year is probably not a good comparison to the ongoing situation. Regardless, with unstable terrain, severe flooding, and continuing landslides, it is unsafe for anyone to operate in or be near the landslide site. This week's landslide is comparable in terms of the level of destructiveness, albeit without any confirmed deaths, to the presumably larger volume Goldau landslide in 1806. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel member Maria Grubisa for supporting my work.